All a library is a series of code routines that you're going to reuse. So you, rather than actually writing it yourself, you'll go and get it from something that's already been written, a code library. So that's where the idea comes from. You're reusing blocks of code that have come from somewhere else. Implementationally, you can do that in many different ways. I mean, the simplest thing is to think about a program. So if we think about a programming language like C, it's made up of a series of functions. So we might have a function called int comp, and that doesn't actually have any parameters, and that's going to call another function, and we'll call it printf, and it's going to say hello Computerphile, like that. So that's a thing, and this is calling another function, and when we compile a C program or any programming language, the computer takes that code and converts it into machine code, and then we execute that machine code version, whether we do that instantaneously if we're interpreting it, or we compile it and execute it later, or a mixture of the two, immaterial for this point of view. So we've got to find this printf. Now, we could just have that defined in the program straight after, so it might actually say something like void printf, whatever the implementation of printf is there. That could be in our source file as well, and then that might use something else, and so they would all be in. So we could put all the code we need for a program in one file. We compile that, we convert it into one machine code program, and then we can use it. That's great, except our program is going to get bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. And as you write more and more programs, you'll find that actually every program is going to use printf, and every implementation of printf is going to be the same. So what you probably would do is you would start off writing a new program. You'd say, okay, I need a printf. So you go and find a copy of the previous printf, and you cut and paste the code from that one into your new one, and you carry on using it, and so on. So you could just do that. But your programs are still going to be huge, long things, and finding things inside there is going to be complicated. So what you start to do is you say, well, actually, I'm going to collate various different routines that I use. Well, I probably use printf a lot. I probably need something to read from the keyboard, scanf in C terms. I'm probably going to need something to do some file IO and so on. And you're going to end up with a series of routines that you're pretty much going to use in every program. And so you collate them together, and then when you write a program, you copy them all into that program. So that's what you could do.
If some of these are used that often, why are they not embedded in the programming language itself?
So why is it? Well, because you might not need them. Why does C not have a print command? Good question. You'd have to ask Brian Kernighan that, because he was probably around at the time there. But I mean, you could take a sort of a purist view of this, is that is printing part of the programming language, or is it something you'd want to do with the programming language? And as C demonstrates, you don't need a print command in your programming language because we can implement it separately. So you can make an argument that you don't need it in there. You need your programming language to have the basis that you need to write everything you want it to write. Okay, you want a library to do image recognition or something. Do you build that into your programming language? Where do you stop? You've got to divide this somewhere. Let's keep the languages simple, and then it makes it easier to write the compiler. If it's easy to write the compiler, you generally know it's relatively easier to check the code works properly. It's simpler, and particularly if you think about the computers that C was developed on, 64K was a luxury, then it makes sense to keep these things small. So anyway, let's say we've gathered together some routines we're using lots and lots. Printf, scanf, file.io, those sort of things. We're going to use some of them, so we just collate them together. And so what we do, perhaps, is rather than starting with a blank file and copying them in, we might actually put them all into a file, and then when we want to start things, well, we copy that file and just add our new code to the end of that and things. Which is okay, but it seems the wrong way around to do it. So what you do is you modify your language to actually have a way of including that file. Rather than having all your things in there, you start off saying, well, I want to include something, and then we'd write a comp routine as we had before. And all that include thing says in C, particularly with the hash in front of it, is copy the contents of that file as if it was at this point in the program. It literally is doing text substitution at this point. It's not doing anything more than copying the text from one. So rather than reading the files from one file, it reads it from the other file and then carries on. It's like concatenating two files together. Your compiler does that, and then it compiles the whole program. Now, that's not what C's doing, but that's the general idea behind a library. We've taken a set of routines that we use a lot, and generally we'll have them that do various useful things that are thematically similar, and we've combined them together, and we're just going to reuse them. So it's a reusable library of code, in the same way that we can have a library of books where you can go and find particular information. And you get a specialist library, so you might have a science library, a sort of fiction library, and so on, in the same way. So you might have a sort of file I/O library, you might have a window GUI library, you might have an image recognition library, a networking library, and so on. You could just include the source file in there and let it work and let the compiler recompile it. But actually, if you think about it, we're taking the same block of code and we're going to convert it to machine code, and that's a deterministic process. It's going to produce the same machine code unless we use a different compiler or we change some of the options. And so actually, the next stage of sort of gathering libraries is that you, rather than combining them or linking them together at the source level, is you say, well, actually, okay, I'm going to go and compile all these libraries to machine code ahead of time. Then when I compile up my program, I'm going to compile the new bits I've just written, and I'm going to link them together with the stuff I've already written. The library code, the stuff that I've already compiled that I've used in every other program. So if we take something like printf, which is in part of the standard C library, so it's a library thing in there. Generally, we will use a pre-compiled version of that. We don't, when we say hash include stdio.h, we're not including the source code for printf. We're including the source code for that tells how to call printf. It just literally say, you need to call it with these parameters and then it will work. What actually happens is there's another program called a linker, which takes the binary that's already been produced for that, the binary you've produced, and combines them together into a single binary program in the right format that the operating system needs, so that it can load them all in one go and run them, and it calls printf to do the things and make it work. So that's all the library is. It's a collection of code routines that probably have been compiled and then linked together to form a complete static binary that can be used. Now, you don't have to do it that way. If we do it that way, then we end up with one binary which has all the libraries copied into it. It's what's called static linking, because it's just one static file, everything you need's in there. You can also do what's called a dynamic linking, which is a dynamic library, where basically all you're doing there is you're delaying that linking process till the program's loaded. And the advantage of doing that is that you can choose which one you load in, and as long as you know where to jump to and how to update things to make things connect together, then you can make it work. So all the library really is, whether it's a static one or source library or a dynamic code library, is a collection of code routines that have been pre-compiled often that you then link into your program to make it work, and it jumps into that other bit of code and then jumps back into yours. They don't even have to be written in the same language. So at some point inside printf, it'll probably call a bit of machine code to actually make the operating system print out these characters on screen and so on. See that this is also connected to the same, the bottom left side of this switch and the bottom left side of this switch and the bottom left side of that one and so on all the way along. We could follow this trace until we get to the last one. It actually changes to the top right for the last couple.